Korea's Covered Interest Parity Deviation, or CIPD, refers to the gap between the cost of borrowing US dollars in the cash market and the cost of obtaining them through FX derivative market. Put simply, it's an extra premium that KRW-based investors need to pay when borrowing dollars in Korea. CIPD is determined by the balance between the demand and the supply in the market for dollar funding. When demand expands or supply contracts, CIPD rises. When the opposite occurs, it falls. To identify the drivers of CIPD fluctuations, panel data on dollar funding demand by sector was constructed. In this framework, foreigners were classified as the main suppliers of dollar funding, while residents were categorized primarily as demanders. The analysis shows that over the entire period, 61% of CIPD fluctuations were attributable to foreign factors, while 39% were explained by resident factors. This indicates that CIPD is significantly influenced not only by foreign factors, but also by changes in domestic demand. For example, when CIPD surged in March 2020 during the COVID-19, the decline in foreign dollar supply accounted for about 84% of the increase, while the rise in dollar demand from domestic agents contributed around 15%. The large-scale quantitative easing by the Federal Reserve and the BOK Fed currency swap helped stabilize the market. Dollar supply recovered and CIPD declined rapidly. In addition, the decline in CIPD in the late 2024 was mainly driven by a reduction of foreign dollar supply, which accounted for about 81% of the change. Fluctuations in CIPD spill over into both the spot FX market and the bond market. When foreigners purchase non-deliverable forwards, NDFs, the foreign bank branches in Korea acting as their counterparties buy spot FX and supply dollars in FX derivative market. As a result, the USD-KRW exchange rate depreciates and CIPD declines. On the other hand, when CIPD rises, foreign investment in Korean won-denominated bonds tends to increase, while residents' investment in overseas bonds tends to decline. Given the interconnectedness between Korea's foreign exchange and financial markets through instruments such as FX derivatives, it is important to move beyond a fragmented approach to individual markets and conduct a comprehensive analysis that accounts for market interconnectedness, making use of micro-level market participant data.